Irving Weissman is deserving of the Wallace H. Coulter Award for Lifetime Achievement in Hematology. And we all owe him a debt for the discoveries he's made and advances in blood biology.
I think he's made a lot of seminal contributions about the development of the blood and immune system.
Irving Weissman is an excellent role model for the next generation of physicians and scientists.
His work was pivotal to protect medical research and advancement opportunities that have benefited us all.
When I was a senior in high school, I had the luck and the opportunity that one of my friends said, you know, there's this lab that is near the lab I'm working in. He says, I think they work on mice. I screwed up my courage and went and met Dr. Ernst Eichwald, and he was very interested in the genetics of tissue transplantation. By the time it was mid to end of the summer, I was sitting in on the lab meetings listening to what they were doing, and it was just all so amazing to me. And ever since then, I've just been following my nose and doing experiments.
Irv really stands out as a scientist for his passion, not only for discovery, but for discoveries that can be translated and his efforts to push that forward.
He and his team were the first to isolate mouse hematopoietic stem cells and then subsequently human hematopoietic stem cells.
After identifying the blood-forming stem cell, it was natural to try to figure out how the blood-forming stem cell goes through these branching decisions to make blood. And as we did that, we could see the difference between the stem cell and the very next cell down.
He then expanded those studies into an exploration of all the different lineages and their production in the blood system, really making the roadmap for how blood development occurs. These studies in normal blood development led him to studies in leukemia, cancer of the blood, and studies about stem cell aberrations in leukemia.
We wanted to know what cell of all those cells in the blood-forming tree develops the leukemia, and which cell becomes the leukemia stem cell.
I think probably one of his greatest discoveries was the CD47 inhibitor action in cancer.
Now, it had already been known that CD47 has a biology in the innate immune systems, which includes cells like macrophages. And macrophages are the eating cells of the immune system.
And that led us to discover that a don't eat me signal called CD47 was in every leukemia. We developed antibodies that blocked the CD47 from binding to the receptor on a big eating cell.
So we set out to test that. And right away we saw that when we used that, the macrophages would eat the leukemia cells, and that prompted us to undergo a whole drug development. And in the clinical trials that have been reported to date, the antibody is showing about a 70% response rate.
He's also played a tremendous role for advocating for additional resources, which have been tremendously impactful for the work of many people.
Irv was one of the first to be involved in the California Proposition 71 and really helped to make that a successful funding opportunity for basic science and clinical translation research in stem cells here in California.
Dr. Weissman did ads on television educating the public about the potentials of this new field, so the public learned not only about the science, but they felt the safety of knowing that they would be protected through this process by extreme commitment to very high scientific and ethical standards.
And the way that he's done that is by reminding everybody that there are patients with diseases that need therapies. And if those patients were your loved one, you would want nothing to be getting in the way of a scientific advance that could help them.
We sometimes call Irv the master stem cell and the godfather of hematopoiesis. We made him a stem cell tree, put him at the top, and then started to track the number of people he's trained, and the impact that they're having has been profound.
I'm most proud of the research that led to the isolation of blood-forming stem cells and their translation, by far. If Coulter hadn't invented his machine that for the first time automatically could identify rapidly large numbers of cells, all of my talk about stem cells would be just talk.
Wallace Coulter was an innovator, and his innovations impacted how we do science across the globe. I would say Irving Weissman is the same. The ideas that he's brought forward, the opportunities that he's made possible in the field, really have resonated within the hematology community and beyond.
It's a tremendous honor, there's no question. And the people who got it before are amongst the greatest people in hematology in the world. Receiving the Wallace Coulter Award has to be among the top awards that I've ever gotten in my life.